Okay, every time, summer if you want it warm, winter if you want to see the snow.
Sure, we'll visit twice.
Okay, for a whole year.
Yeah, sure.
Sir.
Now I'd like to hand over the mic to Mansida. Okay.
Good morning. Is my condition visible yet?
Sure. Yes, it's coming up.
Yeah. What are you looking at is the Mysore Palace. Being an avid traveler, I have visited most of the monuments in India, but the one most mesmerizing was this one. I will give you first an introduction, then a bit of history, architecture, and some special things. The Palace of Mysore is a historical palace in the city of Mysore in Karnataka, which is in south of India. It's the official residence and the seat of the Bodevas, the Maharajas of Mysore, the royal family of Mysore who ruled the princely state from 1350 to 1950. The palace houses two darbar halls and encroaches a mesmerizing and gigantic array of courtyards, gardens, and buildings. Now, let's talk about how it all started. King Yadu Rai first built a palace inside the old fort in Mysore in the 14th century, which was demolished and constructed for multiple times. Then Maharani Vilas Sarinda and her son, the Maharaja at that time, commissioned the British architect Lord Henry Irwin to build a new palace to replace the old one, which had been turned into ashes by fire. So they needed a new palace. Construction of the current palace was commissioned in 1897 and completed in 1912 and expanded in and around 1940. These are some pictures when it was getting constructed. You can see how it all started. Then let's talk about its architecture. The architecture style domes of the palace is commonly described as Indo-Saracenic and it blends Hindu, Muslim, Rajput and Gothic styles. You must be wondering, why so much styles? Because if you look at India in its map in the globe, it is between many type of silk routes and also the great type of sea routes. So it is influenced by many Western cultures. It's a three-story stone building with marble domes and a 45-foot five-story tower. The palace is surrounded by a large garden. The entrance gate also has the emblem Navibhedi Kadachan, which is in Sanskrit, which means never terrified. These are some examples of the architecture. You can look at the throne room where the king sat, the gallery, and then the Ambavalisa, where all the court and the ministers sat together and made important decisions. Then, let's talk about it more. The palace has three entrances, the east, the south entrance, and the west entrance. There are numerous secret tunnels from the palace, together leading to Sarinavatna and other towers and confidential areas. Then let's talk about what are some special events. During the Dasera festival in the India, the palace is enlightened with 96,000 lights during the 2 month period. These are some pictures when it look what it looks like during Dasera. Now let's talk about some unique rooms there, Ambavalisa, which is used by king for private audiences, and Kalyana Mandapa, a marriage hall which is octagonal shaped. Now thank you. Can I pass on the mic to Akshay Satnagar, who is going to speak on Charminar.
Hey guys, how are you doing? Can you see my presentation yet?
Yes, Charminar.
Okay, so I am going to tell you about the magnificent structure which is Charminar. Now, the Charminar, which was built in 1591 CE, stands in the heart of Hyderabad, which is the state capital of the state Telangana in India. The east side of the Charminar faces the east bank of the Musi River, and to the west it faces the Lal Bazaar, which is famous for its jewelry work. Now, the structure of Charminar, I will talk about the structure of Charminar. The Charminar was built by Muhammad Quli Qutb Shah and is the perfect example of exquisite Islamic architecture with influence from the Persian side. The Charminar is a square structure with each side approximately 20 meters, and it bears four grand arches that limestone, mortar and pulverized marble. These are some pictures of the architectural designs of the Char Minar. Now, relevance at the time of outset. Char Minar was an architectural and mathematical wonder. At any point from the Char Minar, you can see who was entering the city of Hyderabad, and it was used multiple times to prevent the invasion of the city. Now, what makes Char Minar so awesome? What makes Char Minar so awesome is its design and making at that point of time, which was technologically considered backwards. It is India's most beautiful and prestigious structures. And verily, it is a wonder how the architects, mathematicians, and builders succeeded in constructing such a durable and durable structure. Thank you. Now I will pass over the mic to Mritunjay.
Good morning, guys. I will further tell you about Char Minar. Am I audible to you? Can you see my presentation?
Yes.
The Char Minar was constructed in 1591 CE. It is a monument and mosque located in Hyderabad, Telangana, India. The landmark has become a global icon of Hyderabad, listed among the most recognized structures of India. The Char Minar is situated on the east bank of Musi River. The English name is a translation and combination of the Urdu words Char and Minar, translating to four towers. It is listed as an archaeological and architectural treasure on the official list of monuments prepared by the Archaeological Survey of India under the Act, the Ancient Monuments and Archaeological Sites and Remains. Now, let's talk about its history. The fifth ruler of Qutub Shahi dynasty, Sultan Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah, built the Char Minar in 1591 century. After shifting his capital from Golconda to Hyderabad, he built this awesome structure of Char Minar. Because of Char Minar, this landmark became a global icon of Hyderabad. The Char Minar was constructed on the intersection of the historical trade route that connects the markets of Golconda with the port city of Machilipatnam. The old city of Hyderabad was designed with Char Minar as its centerpiece. The city was spread around the Char Minar in four different quadrants and chambers, segregated according to the established settlements.